More interestingly, in a paper from 2014, the entire part 4 has the title Island Universes. Peebles concluded that two broad classes of galaxies, pure disks and elliptical, have evolved in near isolation from their surroundings, as island universes, p. 10. From our viewpoint, Peebles needs the EDW perspective to provide the ontology of dark matter, namely, the ontology of island universes. These are the mega entities that belong to the mega EU.21. Cosmologists believe that dark matter provides, in a way, the stage for the cosmic show, a stage that was assembled when the universe was young, way before the time when stars started to shine and planets started to form, and this stage is still evolving. It is, in short, the supporting structure of the universe. It solves in a single stroke many problems in astrophysics and cosmology, and it provides a self-consistent framework for the structure and evolution of the universe, p. 4. We can make an analogy between a table and the corresponding amalgam of microparticles. The format of that amalgam of microparticles has no meaning. Why this format has that shape? Within the micro-EU, we cannot find any meaning for the format of that amalgam of microparticles. However, everything gets a meaning if we introduce the correspondence between that amalgam of microparticles and the macro table that belong to EDWs. Also, the galaxies have a particular format, their constituents, the planets, move with a particular speed just because they correspond to a disk, a mega disk. 22. If we rotate a disk in the macro EU, a second person, using a microscopic electron, will observe an amalgam of microparticles that is arranged under a disk format, where all microparticles moving with the same speed. So, we can presuppose that, because of the Big Bang and other phenomena, billions of planets of a galaxy have been moving under the format of a disk, all planets having the same speed. These galaxy disks correspond to the mega entities, the mega disks, the mega EU. Working within the unicorn world, the physicists logically believe that dark matter does not emit or absorb electromagnetic radiation, it is dark, and does not have any kind of interactions with the known matter, p. 334. Again, dark matter cannot interact with anything from the macro EU, in which there are planets that form, for us, the galaxies, for instance, it cannot emit or absorb electromagnetic radiation, since it does not exist for the ED entities and ED forces that belong to EDWs. Anyway, working within the unicorn world, many scientists believe that dark matter does not interact with any kind of matter that we know, 23, but it is impossible for us to see the causes of such strange phenomena. Hooper claims that the dark matter is not just out there but it is everywhere, in our world, and at the same time, this new type of elementary particles does not exist, p.v. Also, there is no direct influence or any kind of interactions between the dark matter, the mega entities that belong to the mega EU, and any kind of matter that belongs to EDWs. There are the macro EU, the micro EU, the wave EU, the mind is an EU, therefore, there has to be the mega EU, an EU, in which there is the matter, the mega matter, that corresponds to the indirect effects, i.e., through correspondences, in the macro EU and the macro entities like planets that form, for us, the galaxies and the clusters of galaxies. The dark matter has to be a kind of non-baryonic matter since any star is formed from baryonic, normal matter. 24. There are no interactions between baryonic matter and non-baryonic matter since one kind of matter does not exist for the other kind of matter. The amount of dark matter in a galaxy is determined by comparing the mass of galaxy with its luminosity, mass to light ratio. The evidence of dark matter is by and large gravitational. The discrepancy between the luminous mass and the gravitational mass gives an indication of the presence of a huge unseen mass in the universe, p. 89. Dark matter has an indirect influence on the empty space, but this nothing corresponds to something that belongs to the mega EU. Exactly as an electron does not interact with a planet but with an amalgam of microparticles, the dark matter does not exist for the macro objects, like planets. The galaxies, the planets and the space among them, correspond to an entity that belongs to the mega EU. Nothing can stop us to introduce this idea. The human body is placed between the microparticles and the galaxies, but we can push further the dimension of certain entities. These are the mega entities that have greater dimensions than the macro objects. Just as macro observers, we cannot perceive slash understand the rotation of a galaxy from the viewpoint of a mega entity, since the mega-entity does not exist for the planets that form the galaxies. Most probably, the rotation of a galaxy corresponds to the rotation of a mega-entity, the mega-EU. Today, there are several reasons for supporting the Big Bang, the phenomenon that did take place approximately 13.78 or 13.82 billion years ago. From our viewpoint, exactly as the gravity does not exist for the electron, there are no gravitons, the indirect effects of gravitation exist for the microparticles. 25 What is important is that cosmologists believe that a star appeared with other planets that formed in a flattened disk surrounding it, p. This idea mirrors exactly the existence of the mega-entities. A galaxy, no ontology, formed by planets with ontological status in the macro-EU and the empty space among them, corresponds to a mega-entity that belongs to the mega-EU. Exactly as an electron cannot perceive slash interact with a table, because the table does not exist for the electron, we cannot perceive slash interact with a mega-entity. The mega-entity rotates exactly as a macro-disk rotates in the macro-EU. With external limits, the disk rotates with much greater speed than its center. This analogy is very approximate because the spiral galaxies are not spinning similar to the solid bodies and they do not mimic the motion of the planets around the Sun, where velocity decreases with distance, p. 21. The disk in the mega-EU is not exactly like a disk in the macro-EU, there are different properties of these two disks, the macro-disk and the mega-disk, but we are unable to identify, directly, the properties of the mega-disk. We will be able to identify these properties only indirectly since our bodies are macro-entities that do not exist for the mega-entities. In 2007, writing about Kant's philosophy, Gabriel Vaccarieu concluded that within the EDW perspective, the galaxies are entities different from tables, stones, or even individual planets, and exactly as an electron does not exist in a macro-EU, a planet does not exist in a macro-macro-EU, p. 17. There are no causations that would require direct relationships between the ED entities that belong to two EDWs since the entities from an E do not exist for the entities that belong to an EDW. From indirect observations, we can conclude that the dark matter really exists but in the mega-EU. We return to our analogy between a macro-disk and the corresponding amalgam of microparticles. If a micro-observer observes the rotation of an amalgam of microparticles, without being able to observe the macro-disk, then that micro-observer would introduce certain dark matter for explaining the rotation of the microparticles. For the micro-observer, the macro-disk cannot even exist. We can continue the analogy introducing the rotation of a planet which corresponds to a huge amalgam of microparticles. The micro-observer would need to introduce dark matter slash energy for explaining the rotation of that amalgam of microparticles. In this context, we make an important analogy regarding the relationship between gravity and microparticles and the relationship between dark matter slash energy and macroparticles. Gravity, the curvature of spacetime that belongs to the macro-EU, for microparticles that belong to the micro-EU is quite similar to dark matter and dark energy that belong to the mega-EU for the macro-entities that belong to the macro-EU. A microparticle, a photon, for instance, does not perceive slash interact with a planet, therefore, gravity does not exist for the photon. However, in its trajectory, the photon follows the curvature of spacetime produced by a planet slash galaxy. The photon would think it has to be a dark matter, a dark halo that surrounds this huge amalgam of microparticles. The photon cannot even perceive that the spacetime is curved. We can think that there is a halo of dark matter that surrounds a galaxy, but exactly in the same way, an electron that moves around the proton would ask about certain gravitational force, a planet would ask about the dark matter that surrounds a galaxy. Exactly as the gravitation does not exist for photons, dark matter does not exist for planets, and their galaxies. However, the photons follow the spatiotemporal paths, curved space, between planets, even if a planet does not exist for a photon.